Hi everybody, welcome to Campus Tutorial. I am Arindam. Today I am here with question number 11 of our organic MCQ series. Okay, this organic question bank. Over here I am going to discuss 1500 plus MCQs, and so far I have already covered 10 MCQs. You will get the link in the description box. All of the questions I picked from the previous year's NET questions from NET June 2011. And from June 2011 onwards, I am going to cover all the previous year's questions. Almost every important concepts will be covered. Apart from that, I'll be making such videos, which will be some special videos, which are not exactly the previous year's questions, but this kind of question can be framed anytime. So it is quite helpful for all of you. And those who are just confused how to prepare organic chemistry, those who are already read the standard books but still find some difficulties while solving the questions, for those students I have launched this playlist. This is purely the question answer solving video. Okay, so over here you will just see how to approach a question, how to approach an unknown question, not only from the previous year's question. So in between the previous year's question solving, I will be giving such special topics, special questions, which will be your concept booster, and that will help you a lot. So without a further ado, let's get started. Okay, over here it is a question number 11, which is a special question concept booster. And the question says that if this is a starting material, it is treated with NBS AIBN in the first step and in the second step 10% NaOH, what will be the structure of the product? Now NBS is N-bromosuccinamide, okay? N-bromosuccinamide. So it looks like something like this, okay? So this is the structure of the NBS, and this AIBN has structure like this, and this is basically a radical initiator. Okay, so it can form radical and it can induce a radical chain reaction. So in combination of NBS and AIBN, now from the structure of the NBS you know that there is a bromine, and it can act as a bromine source. In absence of the AIBN, it can act as a Br plus source. But since AIBN is present, so you have to think how the radical will be generated and how the radical induced chain reaction will be occurred. So that is what is important for this context. And you should remember that this combination, this NBS plus AIBN, instead of AIBN, other radical initiator can also be present. So in this case, what it will do, it will specifically give you the bromination at allylic or benzylic position. So this is a very beautiful regiochemical outcome of this kind of reagent. Allylic position is something like this position. So it is a double bond. With respect to double bond, if alpha carbon is present, then that carbon or that position is called the allylic position. And benzylic position is, suppose there is a benzene ring, and with respect to benzene ring there is alpha carbon atom is present, and that is called the benzylic position. So this allylic and benzylic position, if you look at this, there will be bromination. Okay, so in this structure, if you look at the structure, so this part is the aromatic ring, so it is the aromatic moiety, and over here this is the carbon which is a CH3, and this is also another carbon which is another CH3. These two will be the benzylic position, and NBS is given in presence of the AIBN. So as a matter of fact, you will see that if I draw the structure again, okay, so these two position, initially there was CH3 and CH3, now this is a benzylic like position. Okay, so initially bromination will occur. So this is what is happening in this case. So CH2 Br, this kind of bromination will occur. And now we'll look at the second step. Now before going to move on the second step, let's take a look at the brief mechanism of this kind of reaction. Now what happens in this kind of reaction, there is one thing is should be mentioned, that catalytic amount of HBr is also added.
because this catalytic AGBR actually helps this NBS. This is a NBS basically. So if I add catalytic AGBR, it is in the catalytic amount, so it will basically produce this kind of succinimide plus Br2. Okay, now this bromine generation is quite important. Now this catalytic HBr, catalytic amount of HBr is sufficient to carry forward the reaction, because rest of the case is quite simple. Because if you take a look at the structure of the AIBN, okay, so it is something like the structure of the AIBN. Over here you will see the homolytic bond cleavage occurs, and that will basically form N2, okay, nitrogen gas, and two equivalent of this kind of radical, okay, two equivalent of the radical is generated. Now we will think that one by one how it will generate the radical induced chain reaction. So this is our starting material. So what it will do, it will just generate a radical in this position. So as a result of that, you will end up with this kind of radical. And obviously, since it is a benzylic position, okay, so this is a benzylic position, so that is why the radical is quite stable. You know that radical stability is parallel with the carbocation stability. Likewise, benzyl carbocation is stable, the radical in the benzylic or allylic position will be much more stabilized. So that is what is happening in this case. So first step is the radical generation and in the benzylic position. And what happens in the second step? Now don't forget about the bromine which is generated. So that catalytic amount bromine, so that will be present. So it will just grab one Br. So there will be homolytic cleavage of the bromine, and thereby there will be a monobromination. So what happens as a result of that? There will be a bromine in this position and another Br radical. Okay, Br radical will be present. Now what will happen? This Br radical again grab one hydrogen from here. Okay, there will be homolytic bond, homolytic cleavage. So if I just draw it in this way, you can think that CH2H, and now there is a possibility that this Br will grab one H dot from here, homolytic bond cleavage, so thereby producing the CH2 dot. So over here, from here, if I just draw it in this part, so this is the rest of the part of the molecule. Okay, now in the upper part one bromination is present, and in the lower part, so CH2 dot, this radical is forming, and again the generation of the HBr. So that is why I said that catalytic amount of HBr is necessary to carry forward the reaction, because it will again initiate the radical reaction, again the initiate the homolytic bond cleavage of this kind of NBS. Okay, so that is what is happening in this case, and this radical again will grab one bromine from the Br2 molecule by the radical mechanism. So this is the chain reaction what is happening. So in the first step, dibromination occurs. So this is what you are getting after the first step. So I'm just highlighting this one. So this is you are getting after the end of the first step. Okay, now I am erasing the rest of the portion, so that now we'll move on to the next step. So if I erase these parts, now what happens in the second step? NaOH or base is given. So it is a bromine is present, alkyl bromide. So if OH minus concentration is high, so it will basically form a OH. So there will be substitution reaction, substitution of bromine with the which. Okay, now from here you can see this oxygen has lone pair and this Br is a good leaving group. Br minus is good leaving group. Okay, so obviously the internal attack will occur. So it is an internal nucleophile. This OH acts as an internal nucleophile. It will throw out the bromine as a Br minus. So from here you can see, if you check a look at the ring formation, so there is one carbon, 2, 3, 4 and this oxygen center. So total 5 membered ring is forming, and you know that in organic chemistry 5 membered ring formation is quite stable. So this is what happens in the second step. So in the second step you will end up with something like this, and after workup this will be the product. Okay, so only one option says that this kind of ring formation is occurring. So your correct answer will be the option number C. So this concept is quite helpful. So I hope you are already making the notes. Each and every question, what you will do while watching my video, you will take a note. Okay, you will write down the question, and then whatever the problem, whatever the solution approach, just note down and take a fresh copy over here. You just carry on this kind of practice before your examination. Just go through that, so that will help you a lot, because I am here going to solve a lot of MCQs with a very new concept, how to approach those questions. So that will be extremely helpful for you. And apart from that, I will be making some concept booster videos, and you know that some of the playlists are ongoing, like NMR spectroscopy, stereochemistry. So those videos will be coming occasionally. So just keep following Chembus tutorial. If you like the video and like my effort, then don't forget to share and subscribe. Thank you. Happy learning.